When James Davis came to North Carolina and got the dobro for his sons to play on, it wasn't long after that to where my dad was at a barber shop where I had me a little part-time job. I was about 12 years old then, I think, working for a guy named Hubert Swicegood after school every day, sweeping that barber shop out and cleaning up around on Saturdays. But a fella came in there on a Saturday morning and brought an old open-back banjo. When he heard that I was looking for a banjo, and my dad bought it for $2, and took it home, sewed the head up with fishing line, and had a split in it, and I was on my way to learning how to play a banjo. We started looking for a fella in the area that could teach me how to play rolls and had a good syncopated right hand, and that was a fella named Homer Israel, lived up in Hooper's Creek. Homer got me into the thumb, index, middle, and teaching tunes, but the first legitimate banjo tune, my dad had taught me, he had figured out what the chords were, the three major chord patterns, like for an A, you've got this shape right here in the pattern, or this shape. There are three major shapes, the same way that you've got three major chord shapes on a guitar. But anyhow, and I was learning. So I was learning how to play stuff like that behind the fiddle player. Now we're going to get ready to do a tune for you right here. We'll take a short break to reset just a little bit, but here's the first tune that Homer taught me. It's called Cripple Creek. Here we go. Next one.